I've done a little modification to the railway line since last episode. I don't think we're going to quite be able to make it. I think we're going to need a little bit more powered rail. Let's see what happens. Oh, no, we made it. That's fine. Okay. I thought that that was going to be a bit too much for it, but that's all right. And then it continues through that way. Okay, so I've made this little train station, I guess you could call it. Yeah, pretty much. And this is basically where Scott's house used to be. So there's been a few changes, and we'll talk about them in a second, but it's just a chest for where all the minecarts can go when people aren't using them. And that goes... Oh, well, I guess we may as well take a quick ride and have a look. But this goes out to the rail that's on the other side of the town, which is like, it goes out to somewhere special that I'll show you in a later episode. No powered rail on this side yet, but there'll be a bridge here and some other changes. There's the prison over there, and then just up there is where the rail continues. So no, we want to go the other way, so we'll head back. Head back now. So let's just go back in and have a look at some of the other changes that I have made since last time. Wow, it's a bit of a crazy hill. So obviously all of this needs to be powered rail stuff, and it also needs to be decorated a bit nicer. But we'll get there. It's coming along. It's a little bit of a different design. I didn't really have any inspiration for this. I just started building. I like these the little parts on the side for where the track goes down. I think it looks good. It integrates well. And I've even left some of the stone there. Like, they've sort of built around it a little bit. I don't know. It's kind of weird working with half slabs, but also it worked out pretty good. And I'm thinking I will bring that sort of fence around here so people can't just jump on the top of the train station there. So the first thing, I guess, and most notably, is probably this building here. So this has forever been the magic shop, and very recently I have wanted to change the magic shop because it was one of the first buildings I made and I just did not like the look of it. So here we have the new and improved magic shop, I guess. So it's not really a magic shop. I don't know what to call this. It's like an enchanting shop, I guess. But we also have an anvil here for ease of access, and also the ender chest. So that's all pretty cool. Got some little decorations, some pressure plates and things around here. We can get max level with all the bookshelves we've got around the place. And I've kept some of the original design, like it was all made out of this jungle wood, so I've integrated that with some oak and brought in some acacia logs. But we used to have this glass ceiling sort of thing, so I incorporated that once again. Then just over here we've got... Down here is where we shred all the zombies up, and then we can go over this way to see the spawner. Obviously, it's in peaceful at the moment, so that's not going to happen. But yeah, everything is as it was basically down here. A little bit changed, but not too much. Now, another thing that's been driving me nuts for a long time is I got rid of the fishing hut that was here, and I've always wanted to do this sort of dock area. So I've made a start on it. Now we'll go up to the top and have a look from up there, because I like it. I think it looks good, and it's going to serve a few purposes. I think I'm going to put a boat out there, but it's also going to be like a fish market where you can buy all your fish and fishing rods and boats. So that'll be good. But I'm just a little bit stuck with how I want to do... Like, if I leave it like... I've got a few options. I can leave it like this. I can extend it around this whole area. And that's going to be a bit more work. But you'll see what I mean when we have a look from the top. But then the other thing was, I was thinking, should I put, like... You know how on docks they have, like, these big areas that go out here. So like the wood continues out there, and then all of the boats sort of just dock onto the sides of those. I don't know, because it doesn't make a whole lot of sense being like this, I guess, because unless it's just one big, like big boats come in here and just for transportation. I'm not sure. Let's take a quick look up the top. Okay, so if we look out over here, we can see like it sort of cuts off pretty abruptly there. So I'm thinking if we continue it all the way around and maybe even just curve it back a little bit and have that whole sort of nearly like half a circle even. I'm not sure. It's probably going to stay like this for a while and then I'll decide, but it looks much better than it was. So it's always an improvement. We've got our nice little park area out there. I like seeing the dragon egg from here. It looks good. I don't think I've changed too much else. I've basically just been working on those few little projects. Some things that didn't quite require a video because they weren't sort of that exciting, but they had to be done. So they are done now. Oh, well, nearly done anyway. So it's coming along. This place is certainly coming along. Now, while I've been walking around here, oh, I forgot the banner. So I have banners for I haven't even spoken about this, have I? This is something, I didn't talk about this last time either, but the Nether Hub, it's changed dramatically since the last time it's been tried. We may as well go in. Let's have a look. All right, so this is now much closer to what the Nether Hub was supposed to be. I'm sure I haven't shown this off. I think I was going to, and then I forgot. So if I have shown this off, just ignore me for 5 seconds. And but I don't think I have. So Nether Hub's coming along pretty good. Got all that coal up there and getting rid of all the netherrack. Now, I've got separate colors. So there's colors for each sort of quadrant, I guess. And we've got little entrances. So over here, I started doing like, this was just a little sort of storeroom for me to have all my materials so that I could easily make all of this stuff when it needs to be done. This was, I was going to have like grow trees in here and then cut them down so it was easier, but that was a pain. So I don't know, that's nothing at the moment. Now, this is like an empty slot. So if something in the world, we want a nether portal over there somewhere, we can take this one and it'll be good. This one goes down to the nether fortress, but I haven't done anything with it yet. And over here, okay, so this is a little bit more exciting. So a bunch of empty ones, once again, can use all these. Now, I was thinking of putting maybe some shops or something in here as well. It'd be cool if we could put little houses in here, but good luck putting a bed in the nether, right? So this banner here, pretty simple one, but this is Frostshire. So these banners are now hanging around in Frostshire as well. I put a few of them around. I love how they're swaying in the wind. I don't think there's much wind in here. Now, they're basically just supposed to represent the sword and like maybe a snowflake or something like that. So Frostshire, right? Now, over this way, don't think we have any. We don't have any banners. Okay, that goes to, it either goes to the end portal or it goes to the underwater monument. And this one goes to the water monument. This one goes to the end portal. Pretty sure that is how it works. I think that's right. And then over here, we have some more banners, and this one's actually looking good. So this is how they're going to look, basically. But we're not going to go down there. I know you want to go down there. You want to find out what's down there, but this just calm down. This is another town. Elliot and I have been working on a town. It's pretty much complete, but we're going to show it off together when it is fully complete. So these are the banners for that town. I'll explain more of that later. So that's probably why I haven't come in here. I didn't want to give away anything, but it's all right. So been working on this as well. So there's some pretty big stuff happening. This shop. Now this shop was one of the first shops built, along with all these little ones. And it was the furniture shop. Now, for a long time, it had basically everything you could buy was in this shop. Now it's empty. Nothing in here. So I slowly started building all these other shops, and rather than having stairs and everything all in the same one, we've got stairs and we've got fences and wool and all sorts of things in separate shops, that was always the plan. So now this shop has nothing in it. Now, I don't particularly like the design anymore, considering we're doing things that are better nowadays. Now, these are simple, but they're allowed to be simple. I think this is the perfect place for a bank. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start by tearing this thing down, and then we're going to make a plan for what we're going to do with the bank. Now, it may seem useless to build a bank, right? Because there's no money in the game. There's, I guess, valuable things. But what we're going to have is we're going to have vaults under the bank that people can purchase. And it'll be a way for them to store things safely. And it'll be another little interesting thing in the world of Craftless that everybody can use. So, without further ado, let's destroy this place. Really weird. I'm starting to think. I had the doors on the corner here because I was trying to do something different, but I'm starting to wonder whether I should just put them at the front here. I think that might work out a bit better for us. Let's just get rid of some of this. Now, what I want to work out is obviously the vaults are going to be underground. So that's probably going to be the biggest part of the build, and just need to work out how I want to lay out the bank so we can work out how we access the vault. And then after that, it's pretty simple, I think, just a pretty standard building, but I might work on a little bit of a template for how I want the bank to be laid out, and then I'll come back and we'll see what progress we have. Just a small progress report now. So I have worked out a little bit of a layout that I'm happy with, and it's kind of going to go like this, I guess. I'm trying to justify how or why, I guess, it would be done like this, but we'll just roll with it for now and see what happens. So two separate entrances at the front here brings us into the little foyer area here. Then there'll be two doors on either side of the counter here. So this is where you would normally be served by somebody. Obviously, in this world, that's more of a self-serve thing, but if I can ever get some villagers, I will definitely put them in here. And then at the back here, we'll have like the entrance to the vault. So there'll be a double door there, and then this will all be obviously normal floor, but we'll have on either side, we're going to have ladders going down. Now, I would like to do an elevator that goes down, but that's too much work, too much effort, and I couldn't be bothered. So, and it'd probably take up far too much space. So, what we're going to do here is we're going to dig down, which I've already done, and I just wanted to show this worked out really well. So, I just wanted to get to a point that I was fairly happy with the depth, so that nobody's going to accidentally just dig their way into it. Now, I found this little water hole here, so obviously I'm going to have to get rid of the water, but this will be the level that we come down to, and then I'm going to dig out a big section. So this is probably going to take quite a while, but I'll come back when I've dug this part out and show you what it looks like. Now, this might surprise you a little bit. Not the bat, but it is a bit of a bat cave. Look at the little guy. Idiot. Stuck. Go out the hole, moron. Now, this looks like a mess, right? And at first I had it really smooth and like I had everything symmetrical and smooth. And as I was going through, there was some coal and stuff that I started digging out. And I was like, you know what? That doesn't look too bad with the gaps. I mean, some of this might need to change. There was a lot of gravel that fell down. There's some still up there. So it probably will change a little bit. But I'm thinking we have it like it was maybe a cave that already existed. And the people that bought the land knew about it and decided to make a bank or something like that. However, another thing that I want to do, which will probably be a little bit odd as well, is remember how when we first came down here there was all that water there? So I'm thinking we could sort of implement that back into it. So on each side, so I've got this rail just so you don't have to walk all the way to the vault. So I'm thinking if we just sort of knock this out pretty randomly and just have water down here. Thought this could be a bit of a cool idea. Now, what I was actually thinking, I might have to wrap this around a bit, but just have the rail raised above the water, so perhaps the water goes underneath the whole way. And then what we'll have, this probably looks really weird because it's nothing like a vault, right? So it's not going to be just one vault. It's going to be multiple vaults. So for example, we will have perhaps a vault over here, right? This might not be the right spot. I'll work out so they're a little bit symmetrical. But say we've got a vault over there near the back. And then there'll be a large vault that is in here, right? And how do we get across the water? I'm thinking we have separate little paths that you go across over the water. I think it'll be a unique look, so I'm gonna work on that. And once I've got a little bit more of this whole design implemented, I'll come right back. This was a much bigger project than I anticipated. I've been working for hours. And the bank is done. At first, this obsidian is going to look really weird, and some other stuff might look a little bit strange too, but over time, starts to look pretty good, I think. So I decided to go with a bit of a white palette, a little bit of gray in there. But then obviously the obsidian there as well. Now there's a bit of a meaning for this. It's because it's a bank, it's I guess trying to resemble that your money's secure and obsidian's the strongest material. So they're trying to show off that they can protect your money, I guess. For the sake of Craftless, let's say that this is just paint. This isn't really obsidian that they've got there. They've just got like an obsidian colored paint so that we don't have to go through the whole dragon tears thing that I came up with. So let's just say that's a painted color, okay? That's what that is. Now, a few fences and things around here, just as a little bit of detail. Probably could add a little bit more detail in there. I just started to get a bit tired by the end of it. So it's pretty much done. There's a few little things, some decorative things that I'd like to do, but let's go on in. So basically just the teller's office here and just the main foyer. Now we come through here. And this, of course, would be a locked door. But yeah, this is where you would be served normally. And this is the vault. So we've got the little iron door that would normally be locked. But, you know, it's going to be kind of painful to open it and close it the whole time. So we'll just leave it open. Now we've got some gold and some silver in here. Or some pressure plates. And then the real feature we've got just down here, so a iron trapdoor to keep everything secure. But look at this place. Wow, doesn't this look different? Looks like a mess, but it looks awesome. I'm really, really happy with how this turned out. I brought a minecart down. So I thought, I mean, this isn't really necessary considering how long it is, but we could extend it if we ever needed to. But it'll stop with the powered rail at each vault, right? So it's a kind of cool little thing. I should probably put one on the end there so that you can stop it. I guess you just get out here and then push it, maybe. Maybe. Oh, stop. Yeah, you could just break it, I guess. Whoa, I was just going to leave it there, though. So, yeah, what we've got down here, let's just go to one for an example. So you get out at your vault and you've just got to hop across to it. It's not supposed to be an amazing parkour challenge. It's just all, I don't know, it's more atmosphere than anything, but it's just supposed to resemble another thing standing in the way of people trying to steal from your vault. So each of them are the same size. They're just I think it was 5x7. So this is what I mean by finishing touches. Now I wasn't sure whether what I do is just give people a vault like this and they can do whatever the heck they want with it. I'm thinking I've got to put an ender chest possibly in each of them, so it's like a safe place for you to put things in the ender chest. Not sure, I'll have a think about it. I think it'll be better off just having chests in here, because I mean, an ender chest you can access from anywhere, but I don't know, I'll have a think about that. But I made these three wide because I was thinking we could put in a an actual redstone door and not have a lever on here, but maybe have, like, say for example this vault, you've got to put the lever here and open it for it to open, and you have to bring your each lever a bit like a key rather than anybody being able to access it. So yeah, I think that might be what I do. And I was also thinking I might case the thing in obsidian, but depends how difficult that is. I mean, everyone's pretty good on this server thingo that we've got, so we don't really need to worry about anybody actually stealing anything. But obviously I'll need a little way to name all of these as well. So that's basically how it works. I really like these pillars that I put in for a bit of extra support. That's like sort of how it's being held. We've got some hidden lighting up there, which, I mean, it's not particularly hidden, but at least it's just sort of not a big hunk of glowstone or something in your eyes. So That's about it. I think it turned out pretty awesome. I'd be really happy to hear if you've come up with something similar, or if you have any suggestions as to how I could have maybe done something better. But I think it looks pretty good, and there we have it. We now have a bank in Craftless. So, until next time, I'll see you later.
Go kill a dragon. I said we weren't gonna do any story, but we sort of need to get like the basics down.
Brendan lied!
I did lie. I need proper stuff so I don't get killed by a vampire master.